Hey everyone, this is Zach with 8020 Media, here today with a comparison video on the BMW S55 versus S58 engines. A little bit of background info for those who are maybe less familiar with these BMW M engines. The S55 was in the previous generation F80 and F82, M3 and M4, built from 2015 to 2018. In the case of the M3, the M4 lived on a little bit longer from 2015 to 2020. And the S58 is BMW's newest variant of the 3-liter inline six found in the M3 and M4. So the new models are the G80 and the G82. Those came out in 2021 and are the current M3s, making the S58 the current production engine for the BMW M3 and M4. So again, these are both built and manufactured by BMW's M division and found in the legendary M3 and M4 vehicles. They both share the same 3-liter twin turbo inline six design, and they both also share a closed deck block, forged rods, forged pistons, and a forged crankshaft, as well as direct injection with dual high pressure fuel pumps, as well as dual Vanos and Valvetronic, as BMW refers to their variable valve timing and variable valve lift systems. If you look at the specs of these engines, they share a lot in common, especially just looking at the basics. Again, displacement, both twin turbo, both forged rods, forged pistons, very similar bore and stroke between the engines, so a lot of similarities. Ultimately, we could spend a lot of time talking about those similarities, but instead, let's just go ahead and jump right into some of the differences. So right off the bat, the older BMW S55 engine in the M3 and M4 competition puts out 444 horsepower and 406 pound-feet of torque, whereas the S58 in the competition models puts out 503 horsepower and 479 pound-feet of torque. So a pretty good increase of about 60 horsepower and a little bit over 70 torque for the newer S58 over the S55 engine. Pretty good power gains right there just for it being a one generation newer engine. Otherwise, a couple notable differences. The S58 actually has a lower 9.3:1 compression ratio. That's compared to the 10.2:1 compression ratio found in the BMW S55 engine. The S58 also moved from air-to-air intercooling to an air-to-water intercooler. The fuel systems, while they're both direct injected and they both use dual high-pressure fuel pumps, the S58 sees an increase from 200 bar to 350 bar. Quite a bit more capable, quite a bit more pressure in the S58's fuel system, so makes that fueling system a little bit more capable. On the S58, pretty much everything on the newer S58 is bigger, stronger, and better than the S55, and don't want to shine any bad light on the S55, but just really goes to show the S58 is a truly different ballpark and really an excellent engine all around. Jumping into a few topics for the S55 versus S58, first let's talk about reliability a little bit. So both the S55 and S58 are shaping up to be very reliable engines. The S55 did have one fairly serious flaw, which was with the crank hub design. So there were a lot of S55s that started spinning crank hubs, especially as they were getting pushed to 600 plus wheel horsepower. It actually shares the same crank hub as the N55, which that didn't seem to fail much on the N55, especially because so few of them were making that kind of power. And so that was an issue on the S55 that was exposed just because the S55 is capable of making that kind of power so easily. A little bit of a downside to the S55 there, but there are some well-known solutions and some ways to address that issue and avoid running into that. Really nothing too concerning on the S55 outside of that crank hub issue. On the S58, it's still a very new engine. Again, didn't come around until 2019. In models like the X3M and the X4M, but in the M3 and M4 specifically, it's still a very new engine. So time will tell exactly how they hold up. However, the S58 is based on the BMW B58, and so far the B58, which is a little bit of an older engine, has shown great reliability and is really shaping up to be a great engine overall. So hopefully the S58 follows in those footsteps and also ends up being a very reliable engine, which we suspect is the case just based on BMW's recent trend and how things have been trending over the last decade with a lot of these newer twin turbo engines and turbo engines getting a lot more reliable from BMW. Moving on to the next topic, a little bit more exciting when it comes to the S55 versus S58, looking at power and modifications on the two engines. Both, again, as M engines are incredibly capable, they already make great power and torque from the factory. But tuning and bolt-on mods is where they really start to shine and set themselves apart from the rest of the pack. So the S55 on the stock turbos is good for about 600 to 640 wheel horsepower. So very incredible numbers for stock turbos. If you push much above that, that is starting to push the limits of the fueling system, especially if you're running full E85, which is pretty necessary to make that kind of power. The fact that the stock turbos can pump out that kind of power for a 3-liter inline six is incredible. So excellent engine when it comes to tuning and basic bolt-on mods and making massive power. However, it still pales in comparison to BMW's newest S58 engine, which again, already has a 60 horsepower advantage from the factory, but everything else, the design and really just the money and the investment put into the S58 shines when you start modifying and tuning that engine. So the S58 is good for 700 plus wheel horsepower on the stock turbos, which is absolutely incredible to think about a 3-liter inline six engine making that kind of power on the stock turbochargers. Heck, we've even seen 670 wheel horsepower with nothing but a tune and E85. So tune the car, dump some E85 in the tank. You should throw port injection on there just for the safety and having a little bit more headroom in the fuel system. But to make that kind of power with literally just a tune and E85 is insane and pretty unheard of in the automotive world for such a small engine to make that kind of power with so few modifications. There have been a few cases of them being pushed to 1,000 plus horsepower and it looking like the stock internal still had more left in them. The S58 does still need some time to define those upper limits and see what it can truly handle for the long run on the streets. 1,000 wheel horsepower does sound very aggressive, but nonetheless, it's a very stout engine, and we wouldn't be surprised to see the S58 holding up at 800, 900 wheel horsepower for the long term. The S58 further backs up those power figures with its actual real world results. So the S58 in the G80 M3 and the G82 M4, especially in the xDrive all-wheel drive models, they're already getting into the nines pretty easily in the quarter mile with, again, pretty much just a tune and E85. Some might have downpipes in the intake and a couple other little mods, but we're talking about full weight cars running in the nines at about 138 to 142 miles an hour. So incredibly impressive for the BMW S58 engine. The S55 also isn't a slouch with some of those F82 M4s and F80 M3s running in the mid tens at about 133 to 135 miles an hour on the stock turbos. Also very impressive. It might not sound quite as good compared to what the S58 is already achieving in the newest M3 and M4, but still incredible numbers for the BMW S55 engine. Ultimately, really not much else to say in this comparison video. The S55 and S58 are, in my opinion, they're two of the best modern turbo engines, especially looking at six-cylinder engines or engines around the same 3-liter displacement. There really isn't much else out there that can make this kind of power and do it so reliably. In summary, both the S55 and S58 engines are awesome overall engines. They're both showing to be very reliable. Apart from those crank hub issues on the S55, that's really the only major flaw either engine has. Both off to a great start reliability-wise when it comes to power and performance. Normally, if we compared the S55 to almost any other engine, we'd be giving such high praises to the S55 and saying how impressive it is compared to the other engine. But unfortunately for the S55, when you compare it to BMW's newest S58, it just pales in comparison, and the S58 really is such a perfectly designed engine from top to bottom that's truly incredible. That wraps up this video, so if you guys appreciated the content, please hit that like button, subscribe to the channel, and check out the description below for more awesome content on the BMW S55 and S58. Thanks, guys.